Hello everyone, welcome to video lecture series of satellite communication. Today's topic is GPS receiver. So in this video I'll be talking about the basics of the GPS which are required to just for a review purpose. Then I'm going to talk about the major components of the GPS receiver and the block diagram of GPS receiver in detail. Let us begin. First, let us talk about some of the basics of the global positioning system. As you know that the global positioning system, it is a navigation system which is based on the satellite. And GPS has created a revolution in the field of the navigation and position location, and almost all of us are utilizing GPS in our daily life. So GPS are used in a number of applications. In the previous video I have discussed about the applications of global positioning system in detail, but it is mainly used for positioning, navigation, monitoring and surveying applications. The major advantage of the GPS navigation is the real-time positioning and timing synchronization. See, whenever you are using the GPS, you have to travel, you have to move from one point to the another point, you are always getting the real-time information. That is the beauty of this GPS. It means the satellite navigation system, they have become an integral part of almost all the applications. But there is an important factor, mobility. Mobility is a key parameter, so wherever the mobility is being like identified or observed, it could be used. Some of the technical structure of global positioning system, its basics. See, GPS space segment, it consists of 24 satellites orbiting in medium Earth orbit. And these satellites are located, these orbits of the satellites are located at a height of 20,200 kilometer, and the orbital inclination is 55 degree. And all these 24 satellites are clustered in a group of 4, means in a single group 6 satellites exist. Orbital period for the satellite, it has been already calculated, and it is about 1/2 of the sidereal day, that is 11 hours and 58 minutes. And the large number of GPS receivers can operate simultaneously. So there is not a limitation that only one or two receivers or some limited number of GPS receivers can operate. Many GPS receivers can operate effectively. There is one more location principle is available which can be utilized, and its name is LORAN. LORAN is a long range navigation. It is also used for the positioning location principle, but the accuracy and reliability of LORAN, it is less in comparison to the GPS. GPS provides us 24 hour service worldwide. It is very accurate and it provides us three dimensional location information means the information about longitude, latitude and altitude. It gives continuous real-time information, and unlimited number of users can utilize this service. Number of users are not limited. This is also a major advantage for the GPS. Now, in its continuation, first let us understand what are the major components of the GPS receiver, and after this we are going to talk about the block diagram of GPS receiver. So the major components of GPS receiver, you can see there is a antenna, RF section, tracking is required, there is a precision oscillator, microprocessor, memory, power supply, command and display unit, and external data logger. Let us discuss one by one. See, when we talk about the receiving antenna, what is the use of the receiving antenna? Definitely, whatever the information the satellite is transmitting, that must be received by the receiving antenna, and then only that information is processed by the GPS receiver. So the receiving antenna is very sensitive, and GPS receiver, it detects actually electromagnetic wave which is transmitted by GPS satellite, and this electromagnetic wave, it needs to be converted, the wave energy to the electrical current, then this electrical current will be amplified and accordingly signal strength will be reached and then it will be sent to the receiver electronics. Commonly used receiving antennas are monopole, dipole. Now these are not commonly used, but sometimes it may be used, but spiral antenna are used, spiral helix, quadrifilar helix, quadrifilar helix antenna is commonly used, microstrip or patch antenna is commonly used. So you must remember how many antennas are used. And one more you can list down, choke ring. This antenna is also used as a receiving antenna. Then you can see there is a next signal processor where code tracking and tracking loop is being mentioned. See, actually the RF section with signal identification, that is a very important section in the case of the GPS receiver. So what happened? The incoming GPS signal must be down converted first, which is the R requirement. So it must be down converted to a lower frequency in RF section, and then it must be proceeded with one or more channels. So what happened? The receiver channel in the primary electronic unit of GPS receiver, it is important, and a receiver may have one or more channels. So it is not required that only one channel must be present, and there is a like beauty that the parallel channel concept is utilized over there. But for parallel channel concept, each and every channel is continuously tracked. That is why there is a requirement of the tracking loop. So when each and every channel is continuously tracking one particular satellite, and a minimum of 4 parallel channels is required to determine position and time. Minimum of 4 channels are required whenever we require the location and time. But some of the modern receivers, they contain up to 12 channels for each frequency, and this continuous tracking of parallel channel, this is not very tedious task. Even it is relatively cheap and it gives a very good performance over there, right? Then there is a microprocessor you can see over here. So to control the operation of the GPS receiver, microprocessor is an essential component which is required for acquiring the signal, processing the signal and decoding the broadcast message. So this is what microprocessor is required. There is a precision oscillator. So a reference frequency in the receiver is generated, and that reference frequency is generated with the help of the precision oscillator. It is usually less expensive, and low performance quad oscillator can be used in the receiver because precision clock information, it is obtained from the GPS satellite, right? Then you can see power supply. Here external power supply is mentioned. See, first generation GPS receivers consumed very high amount of power, but the modern receivers, those receivers are designed such that they consume very little amount of energy. So earlier the first generation, second generation, they required high power, so there was a use of the external power supply. But nowadays in the modern receiver, because they consume little energy, so most of the receiver have an internal rechargeable batteries, and that rechargeable batteries is of nickel cadmium. So these are the rechargeable batteries. Then you can see memory. So memory is required for port processing operations. The data needs to be stored, and the data may be internal or external memory devices used for. So that is why memory is used, and accordingly external data logger is also required. See, post processing is a very essential like purpose or the requirement or a step for the multi-station techniques. Means if we talk about the GPS observation for pseudo range, phase data, time, navigation message. So all these data needs to be recorded. So that is why there is a requirement of the memory, and modern receivers have internal memories of about 5 megabytes. This is, I'm talking about the modern receivers, or more than 5 megabytes. But some receivers require some of the data or the magnetic tape on a hard disk which is to be stored. So there is a use of the external data logger, and this external memory is connected through RS-232 port. Command and display unit. Whatever the information or the decoding is done by the microprocessor, so if required, the command needs to be sent, or the command can be displayed by the use of this unit. Now, let us draw the GPS receiver block diagram. Here you can see various components, and since I have explained the function and the requirement of each of the component which are required in the GPS receiver in detail, so I hope now you will be able to explain it, this particular GPS receiver block diagram. You can see initially there is a receiving antenna. See, GPS receives, this receiving antenna receives the signal which is being transmitted from the satellite. This receiving antenna is very sensitive, and it receives the satellite signals, and it is mainly a circular polarized antenna. This is a circular polarized antenna. Then you can see next is a low noise amplifier. So low noise amplifier amplifies the weak received signal. Then down converter, you can see it converts the frequency of received signal to an intermediate frequency signal, down conversion. Then IF amplifier, which amplifies the intermediate frequency signal. After that, you can see there is an analog to digital converter, ADC. See, ADC performs the conversion of analog signal which is obtained from IF amplifier, the previous stage, and it performs the conversion from analog to digital, assuming all the sampling and quantization blocks are present in this ADC. Then you can see DSP, digital signal processing. Digital signal processor is available, and this digital signal processor, it generates course acquisition code. So this is why this digital signal processor is required. Microprocessor, you can explain, it performs the calculations about the position, provides the timing signal so that to control the operation of the other digital blocks, and it also sends the useful information to display unit to display on the screen. And display, which is required to display whatever the like information or message needs to be displayed. Here I have listed down the function of each and every block which is present in the receiver. I have already talked about the function of each and every unit in detail. Thank you so much for watching this video.